now he is demanding bread. Why don't you give a piece of bread to him? Then the king can reply, if I give a piece of bread, he will come here again and he won't stop shouting and it will be a headache for us. So this way you have to continue the conversation. So this creativity of making dialogues, making conversations, making thoughts of the characters, that is what we demand from you. So a thorough understanding of the text is highly essential from your part. And there is a simple discourse placard, it is very easy for you. The context is, imagine the king in the play, the beggar and the king, has decided to ban begging in his country. He ordered his servant to prepare a few placards in this regard. Can you help the servant to prepare some placards? You know the features of a placard, it must be brief, only content words can be highlighted. It must be attractive, it should have a message. So what message we should convey through the placard here? The king is against beggary. So one is given here, beggary is prohibited, or begging is prohibited. Ban beggary, beggars will be prosecuted. Like that, similar placards you can prepare. So find out maximum questions like this and write the answers of your own. That will boost your confidence. And here is a letter, just think about the questions of this. What can be the question of this letter? I will read the letter for you. Dear Amit, hope you are keeping fine. After reading the one act play, The Beggar and the King, my friends have decided to stage it in connection with our school day celebration. We know you are an expert in staging plays. We request you to help in this matter. Hope you will come over here and give us proper guidance. Expecting your favorable reply. Yours lovingly, Dinal. So this is a very simple letter, and this letter also question asked by taking a context in the one act play. So after reading the one act play, the friends in your school or the classmates in your school have decided to enact the play on the day of school day celebration, but you are not in a position to stage it without the help of an expert, and you came to know that a friend. So this should be the question. Imagine that you wanted to invite one of your friend who is expert in staging the play, and for that purpose you are writing a letter to him. What would be the likely letter? This way a imaginary context will be created in the evaluation text, and you have to write the letter in tune with the context and the demand of the question paper. And here is another example, and all these are taken from or based on the first literary piece, that is The Beggar and the King. The encounter means the argument or the meeting with the beggar distressed the king greatly. The king got disappointed because he had a tough argument, a strong argument with the beggar. So he became restless and thought about the beggar. What might be the thought of the king? Write it in a short paragraph. So after sending the beggar away out of the palace, after some time, king began to think, actually what happened to me? Why has he come? So the thoughts of, you are supposed to write what happens in the minds of the king, in the mind of the king. That thoughts you should depict in a very good language. That is what we demand, write a paragraph about thoughts or a diary entry of the character. Now here is an example. What a strange man he was. Was he really a beggar? Was he really hungry? He might be a wise man. He might be teaching me a great lesson. A hungry man will lose all his control when he is denied bread. Hunger has no eyes or ears, even fear of death. As a king, it is my duty to see that all my subjects get enough food. Am I right in trying to punish him? No, I have done something wrong against him. I must repent. So here, this paragraph depicts or describes the thought of the king. So you have to put yourself in the shoe of the king and should write the thought of the king. This is what we expect from you. So practice this kind of answering these kind of questions. Friends, another important discourse that you can expect is the character sketch or describing a character, maybe of a character of a play or a story that you have read. So a analytical study, you should analyze the features, the characteristics of each character in the story and the play, then only you will be able to perform better here. And let us analyze the characters of the one act play, The Beggar and the King. The most prominent character is the beggar. Even the title is The Beggar and the King. So the sympathy of the author rests with the beggar, not with the king. Usually king comes first, but here the beggar comes first because beggar is more important because he represents the common people, the landless people, the poor, the needy, the downtrodden. So the beggar is the beggar in the one act play is an ideological image. He is not an individual. He represents the society at large, the common masses, the majority who are suffering in the world. I have told you he is a type. He is not an ordinary individual. He represents the sad plight of the poor and the landless. He speaks a lot, quite powerfully. While you were going to the drama or the one act play, you have come across the language, the words, the expressions that the beggar used. So he was very confident and he was very strong about his convictions. And he speaks very powerfully, and that too against the ruler. So when the people get strength, they will question the authority using all their power. That is what happened in the palace. The beggar has a strong determination to fight for his rights. He tries to bring out the insignificance of the king. He is assertive in the beginning of the play. Later, he becomes more demanding, commanding, and aggressive. Friends, this is how you have to go on describing the character.